Let's check on European markets first. They are down in afternoon trade after hotter than expected U.S. inflation data overnight stoked worries the Fed will keep rates higher for longer. Investors also bracing for the European Central Bank's policy decision. While the ECB is expected to keep its key rates unchanged, traders will be looking for signals for a June rate cut. As for Wall Street, futures are also pointing to a lower open for the major U.S. indices ahead of another key inflation report, the Producer Price Index.
Here are some stocks to watch out for. We're monitoring shares of Société Générale after it agreed to sell its equipment financing unit to French rival BPCE for over $1 billion. The French bank shares rose 0.8%. Also in focus, shares of AstraZeneca, which plans to raise its annual dividend by 7% for 2024, ahead of a shareholder vote on its CEO's pay package. Shares of the drug maker last traded higher by 2%. We're also keeping a close watch on shares of U.S. Steel. Politico reported the U.S. Justice Department has opened an antitrust investigation into Nippon Steel's takeover of U.S. Steel. Shares of the steel producer fell 0.6% before the bell.
Asian markets ended Thursday trade mostly lower. Japan's Nikkei 225 shed 0.3%, while Australia's ASX 200 snapped a three-day winning streak. Here at home, Philippine shares resumed their slide as they returned to trade from a two-day holiday. The main index stumbled back to the 6,600 level, now down for a sixth straight session.
Don't panic. I think we're still good. So far, the technicals are holding up, the fundamentals are holding up. This is likely just a knee-jerk reaction. And again, it's quite overdone in my opinion. So I'm still a buy on dips kind of guy, and I think this is the dip that we're talking about. So just a bit more cautious trading, but still be optimistic for the rest of the year.
The Philippine government eyeing around $100 billion in investments as a result of President Marcos Jr.'s historic trilateral meeting with U.S. President Joe Biden and Japanese Prime Minister Fumio Kishida. Manila's envoy to Washington, Juan Manuel Romualdez, says the investments are expected to materialize in the next 5 to 10 years. Romualdez adds a lot of the investments may be in the semiconductor industry and energy sectors. Marcos is expected to hold talks with small modular nuclear power companies on the sidelines of the trilateral summit. Romualdez also says they're looking at forging a free trade agreement with the U.S. on cyberspace and digital technology.
A lot of areas where we are putting ourselves, our economic managers are putting our country into a situation where we're opening up our economy, especially in energy, which is very important for us, and also, of course, in digital infrastructure and infrastructure, physical infrastructure, as also one of the other aspects of our economic package that we'd like to offer for potential investors.
Meanwhile, U.S. National Security Communications Advisor John Kirby says there's no reason for China to, quote, overreact to multilateral strategies happening in the region. That's after the Philippines, Australia, Japan, and the U.S. conducted maritime drills in the West Philippine Sea.
This is about freedom of navigation. It's about adherence to international law. It's about proving the simple point that we and our allies will fly, sail, and operate wherever international law permits us to do. And it does in the South China Sea, and we did.